press subscribe button followed by bell button and click all to get more topics.
Good morning, students. In today's class, we are going to discuss about intermolecular forces, okay, in the chapter States of Matter. Before starting the content, I'll put forward some questions for you to think over and listen to this lecture. At the end of this class, you all will be capable of answering those questions. My first question is, at room condition, you know that in this universe, there are some chemical substances. Everything is chemical substances. But there are some chemical substances. They exist as solid, some are liquid, and some are solid gases. What is the reason why some chemical substances are solid, some are liquids, and some are gases? This question naturally comes in our mind. Then you come to these individual states. In solids, there are some solids which are having high melting point, higher boiling point. Some are having lower side, lower boiling point, lower melting point. Come to the solubility. Some solids are more soluble in water and some are less soluble in water. Some are more soluble in water but not soluble in organic solvents like benzene and other hydrocarbons. Then again, same like that in liquids also, there are some liquids, they have high volatility, some are low volatile. Some are more soluble, some are less soluble. Surface tension, vapor pressure, these are all the properties of these liquids. Some liquids are having low value, some are having high value. Similarly, for gases, some gases are more soluble. Ammonia is highly soluble in water. HCl is highly soluble in water. Whereas some gases, hydrogen is very less soluble. Oxygen, some minimum solubility. So, this solubility of gases in water also differs. And then some gases, when you compress, they are easily liquefied. Some gases, they are not easily liquefied. Then, what is the reason? See, all these questions can be easily answered once you learn about what is intermolecular force and what all the different types of intermolecular forces acting on the substances. Okay, so now, first I will be giving the explanation for why some substances are existing as a liquid, solid and gases at room condition. It is because of a competition between intermolecular forces versus thermal energy. So what is this intermolecular forces? It is a physical attraction. Here in this discussion, I don't take these ionic substances because they will have some other kind of discussion that in the separate lecture will include that. Here we consider only covalent molecules, maybe solid like sugar, urea, glucose, liquids, water is a very good example, and any gas, carbon dioxide, even water vapor, hydrogen, helium, neon, these all. Okay, so you take these type of covalent molecules, they may be monoatomic, diatomic or polyatomic molecules, doesn't matter. Okay, so here, in case of intermolecular force of attraction, that is a physical attraction. It is not at all a chemical bond, it is not an ionic bond, it is not a covalent bond. It is two molecules, through their body they will interact with each other. That's why it's a physical attraction or interaction. Interaction is a common word for repulsion and attraction. Okay, but always attraction predominates. That is why they come closer. Otherwise they cannot come closer to become liquid or the liquid to become solid. Okay, so intermolecular forces of attraction, physical attraction, and it is not a chemical bond. And another one information is, it is always weaker than the chemical bonds, ionic bond and covalent bonds. Even it is quantitatively it is given that 15% of the strength they will possess when compared to the strength of ionic bond and covalent bond. Okay, and finally, these intermolecular forces of attraction is electrostatic in nature. So don't think that, sir, you just now told ionic compound I will not include. It is having separate discussion because ions will be present in that. Yes, but here this electrostatic in nature means what? There will be a kind of positive, not positive charge, there will be a kind of positive feeling and negative feeling, and these positive feeling and negative feeling will attract. That type of electrostatic interaction will be used for explaining these intermolecular forces of attraction. But not that ions. If I say positive charge, it is cation. Negative charge, it is anion. But that's why I told you it is a positive feeling in some places of the molecule and negative feeling in some other places of the molecule. We are going to discuss in detail what is the reason for those positive and negative feelings. Right? Next, I am coming to thermal energy. What is thermal energy? It is at a particular temperature, the chemical substances, that means they are made of molecules. These molecules will possess some energy. That is thermal energy, we say. What is the difference between this thermal energy and intermolecular forces? These intermolecular forces will help or will account for bringing the molecules closer because they are attracting. The molecules will come closer to each other. Whereas in thermal energy, the molecules will possess more energy, so they will like to move away from each other. So this thermal energy accounts for taking the molecules or moving to cause movement of molecules away from each other. And this thermal energy depends upon temperature. And here intermolecular force of attraction also depends on temperature. How? Intermolecular forces of attraction will be less effective at high temperature. The reason is they will have more energy, thermal energy. So they will overcome this intermolecular force of attraction. They will try to move. So at high temperature, intermolecular forces of attractions are less effective, thermal energies are more popular, more pronounced at high temperature. But what about lower temperature? In lower temperature, the molecules will possess low thermal energy. Therefore, the intermolecular force of attraction will dominate. The overall effect will be the molecules will be brought closer to each other. Okay, and this thermal energy, it is actually a measure of kinetic energy. There are kinetic energy, you know, depending upon the temperature. Higher is the temperature, higher will be the kinetic energy, and higher will be the thermal energy. Okay, so this movement of molecules on account of its thermal energy generally called as thermal motion. Okay, and now again, you think about this solids, liquids, and gases. In solids, the molecules are very tightly packed. The reason is that the intermolecular force of attraction is very, very effective, very strong and effective, and at that particular temperature when compared to the thermal energy. See, do not forget that at a particular temperature, the molecules of a substance will possess both intermolecular force of attraction and thermal energy. And whether they will become, they will exist as a gas, liquid or solid, that will be decided by the magnitude of these two. If suppose intermolecular force of attraction is an overweighing factor, it predominates, it is more than the thermal energy possessed by the molecule, definitely the overall net effect will be molecules will be tightly packed. That is what the solid. So at room temperature, if any substance existing as a solid means its intermolecular force is very much higher than the thermal energy. Okay, this you take it as IMF, and this is just for discussion. It is not an accepted abbreviation. Okay, and in case of, then what will happen here, the solids are tightly packed, so they will not have a movement, the molecules cannot move and they can only vibrate, so they will have a vibrational movement only will be there. And coming to gases, here what happens, the thermal energy is much higher than that intermolecular force of attraction, because that at that particular temperature, that the molecules of the substance, they possess very high thermal energy and the intermolecular force of attraction is low, less effective. So this thermal energy will dominate, molecules will freely move, so these molecules will have translatory motion, but here only vibration. In their own place they will vibrate. Then you may think that, sir, you told at a particular temperature, room temperature, why here thermal energy is low, intermolecular force of attraction is high, here thermal energy is more and intermolecular of force of attraction is low. That is depending upon the nature of the chemical substances, nature of the molecules. That's what we are going to study today after this discussion is completed. Okay, so here, in case of liquid, what happens, here that intermolecular force and thermal energy, here intermolecular force only dominating, but not very, very strong like solids. So they will be tightly held together, but they can have a translatory motion. And they can have a translatory motion, but they are not completely free to come out. You see, you take a beaker containing some liquid. Okay, this liquid A you take it as. So that means many A molecules are there. And these A molecules can move. They can move inside. That means they are having translatory motion. And at the same time, this A cannot come out. It cannot be completely freed, because the intermolecular forces of attraction is less than solid, but not very less. Not very less, in such a way that the thermal energy will overtake that, and it will be more than that, and so that the molecule will come out. That will not happen. Okay, so these things you understand. Then I told about many properties of solids and liquids and gases, like solubility and vapor pressure, surface tension. These are all the bulk properties. The first thing is measurable properties. We can measure experimentally. They are measurable properties. But these properties are shown by bulk of the substance. Very one simple example to understand. You consider one molecule of water. It will not have any of the properties, like it will not boil. It will not show that property which was shown by bulk of water. If you have some 1 ml of water, 10 ml of water, it will boil and visible to you. You can see that. The changes can be measured, can be seen. Directly or indirectly, pressure, you can see that vapor pressure, and pressure, the pressure varying, that mercury level will be increasing and decreasing. You can see that there is something changing taking place inside. So these measurable properties are shown by bulk of the substances, but still the reason for these properties, why that property is high in some molecule, why it is low in some other substances, this reason for these properties which are different in different substances is associated with the individual molecule and its nature. That is why it is important to study about these intermolecular forces, which I will be explaining at the molecular level. Okay, so next we are going to study about the different types of intermolecular forces of attraction. See this, I have listed the different types of intermolecular forces. Dipole-dipole force, dipole-induced dipole, and London force, which can also be called as dispersion force, and more names I will be telling during the individual discussion, and the hydrogen bond. These are the different intermolecular forces, of which the first three are collectively called as by the name van der Waals forces. The scientist van der Waals only was dealing with these intermolecular forces. So in his name, these first three are called van der Waals forces, and this hydrogen bonding is always separately discussed, because it is applicable for some limited number of elements. You will come to know when we discuss about that. Okay, remember this point. Now we'll be discussing about these intermolecular forces one by one. The first one is dipole-dipole interaction. Here this dipole-dipole interaction means, first of all, you understand it is between two polar molecules. Okay. Between two polar molecules, and the electrostatic in nature, I told you, that is between the opposite charges or charge feelings, I like charge feelings. The two opposite one, positive feeling and negative feeling of the different molecules will attract. Okay, so two polar molecules, it means between two polar molecules, that means here the first thing you remember, this will happen only in polar molecules. Okay, if the molecule is polar, then only we can talk about dipole-dipole attraction. What is polar molecule? That it is, we cannot discuss here. You should have known that the polar molecule, non-polar molecule under the discussion of dipole moment. Anyway, polar molecule means, you see, I will represent by this symbol. Okay, and you have to understand each and everything. Instead of this, even I can take this. This is all we are using these symbols or these type of pictures for representing a molecule. This I will be using as a water molecule. You just imagine this is water molecule. If it is a non-polar, what will happen? This non-polar means we will draw this shape like this. Okay, but this is water, is not a non-polar molecule. So here Cl2, Br2 means this structure will come. But another one is, so I am just drawing this diagram. So this is H2O. This what this this side broad and this side that width means a small size, that is because it represents the electron cloud. Electron cloud in one side of the molecule, electron cloud in another side of the molecule. This will happen due to the difference in electronegativity. I don't want to go into detail that you go through the dipole moment and polarization process and all. Okay, so in case of water molecule, oxygen is more electronegative, hydrogen is less electronegative, so there will be a negative, so the negative feeling I told, na, this delta minus, and this smaller side represent pictorial representation, it is representing the electron cloud. So here it is wide, now that is you take more electron cloud, it is representing less electron cloud, that is positive feeling, nucleus will dominate. So every polar molecule will have this charge feeling. One side delta minus. So delta is actually the symbol. It is very, very, very small. That is very small. Very small feeling. The delta is meant for that. Okay. So if I write without delta, it is anions, cations. Here it is not anions, cations. It is a neutral molecule. As a whole, water is neutral. But in one portion of the water molecule, there will be a negative charge feeling. And on the side, it will be a positive charge feeling. Okay. So similarly, here I take this some other example, because water will have a very intensive hydrogen bonding. So after studying hydrogen bonding, you will understand. So I take without hydrogen bonding, one hydrogen chloride gas. Here this hydrogen chloride gas, when it is compressed, it is easily liquefied. This is a fact. Experimental result. You try with a chlorine gas. The chlorine gas is not easily liquefied like this hydrogen chloride. I mean, what is different? That because of this dipole-dipole interaction, first of all, this will have a charge feeling of positive on the hydrogen side and chlorine side more electronegative. So this is called a polarization. The molecule HCl is a polar molecule. Now for pictorial representation, I draw this. This is the HCl molecule. And here there is a delta plus and delta minus. There is a charge separation is indicated. So when you are compressing or when you are bringing the molecules closer to each other, why we have to bring the molecules closer to each other? Because here it has been given quantitatively. It is found that these intermolecular force of attraction, that energy involved, no? That is called interaction energy. When they are attracting, how much energy will be given up? Understand each and every point here. Whenever two things are attracting, they become lower energy. Attraction leads to stability. Attraction is a stabilizing factor. So whenever two molecules are attracting each other, they will get stabilized. How they will get stabilized? By losing energy. By doing so, they will become lower energy. Their potential energy will become low. Lower the energy, higher will be the stability. Okay, so that energy released now as a result of this interaction, that is called interaction energy. And this interaction energy is inversely proportional to, I'll use the distance d. Distance between the two HCl molecule. Suppose here another HCl molecule comes. The distance between that HCl molecule to the power 3, this is for stationary molecule, if the molecules are assumed as stationary position. Otherwise, they are 1 by d to the power 6. This is for moving molecule. That generally, molecules will be moving. You see, what message is conveyed? The interaction energy, more is the interaction energy, more stronger will be the attraction. Because stronger means more energy will be given out. More stabilized. So, more is the interaction energy, that when that interaction energy can be more, and this denominator should be very, very small. Okay, so that is the distance between the molecule should be very small. Otherwise, if it is slightly away also, we cannot talk about dipole-dipole moment or any other. All the interactions are distance-based, very, very close distance only they will be effective. We cannot speak about that if they are far away from each other. Okay, so now these HCl molecules attracting this mean. Now tell me, this is delta minus, delta plus, and now here the molecules cannot attract. And now see that here another one HCl situation I am writing, delta plus, delta minus, and here HCl, this is delta plus, delta minus. Here there is an attraction. This attraction is there. The molecules will attract. Just only one side I have shown. Otherwise, you see, there is a HCl molecule having the polarity like this, delta plus, delta minus. In this side, many other HCl molecules can attract. HCl, when they are compressed, they will come closer in such a way that their positive ends approaches the negative end. You see that this is negative end, so these positive ends will attract. This side, who will attract? The same HCl, but here the negative end will approach. Negative end will approach this also. Okay. This is how they will attract. So when you are compressing, automatically the opposite charge feelings will be, I told the delta minus, delta plus is a charge feeling due to electron cloud. More means negative feeling, electron cloud less means is a positive feeling. That the electron cloud less is because it is less electronegative, so the more electronegative atom will be pulling the electron cloud there. So here nucleus will dominate, that is why positive feeling. Here electron will dominate more than the nuclear effect, so it is negative feeling. So the opposite charge feelings will be attracting each other. Okay, so this force is also called Quisson force. It is also, you know, it is also called Quisson force. Okay. Now, what are the factors at which these particular dipole-dipole attraction depends on? The first one is molecular size. Molecular size and molecular mass, I'll try to molar mass. Okay, so this attraction of molecules via dipole-dipole is depending upon molecular size. Higher is the molecular size, so here higher will be the interaction energy. So this interaction energy is directly proportional to the size and the molar mass. Size is bigger means naturally they will possess higher molar mass. See, this is, I am not saying that experimentally found. Using this, I have already placed some molecules for comparison. See this, leave that last one. The first one, you see, HCl boiling point order I have given. First of all, what is boiling point? When boiling, liquid is converted into gas. In liquid, the molecules will be close with each other. And now you are separating the molecules. For separating the molecules, what you have to do? You have to overcome. You have to overcome the intermolecular forces of attraction. Intermolecular forces, these forces should be overcome. But that will be done by heating. So when you are heating, this will be completely overcome and they will start boiling. That is boiling point. Now boiling point is a measure, boiling point is an indication of how strong the intermolecular force of attraction is present. Here all I have shown a polar molecule. Is the polar molecule, it is a polar molecule, it is polar molecule, but how much polar that we can understand from the boiling point order. More is the polarity, more will be the interaction, therefore more will be the boiling point. And you see that boiling point is high for HI. The boiling point is high for HI is it is because of this constant. This is one of the reason on which, one of the factors on which this dipole-dipole interaction depends on. And the dipole-dipole interaction only will decide the boiling point in case of polar molecules liquid. Okay, so here molecular size is more means then that interaction will be very high, directly proportional. You see that chlorine smaller and bigger. This is actually one hydrogen and one chlorine. And this is one hydrogen and one bromine. And this is one hydrogen and one iodine. See that this is the difference. Size increases. And naturally molar mass also, that is 5.5. 127 for that halogen atomic masses, that means the molecular mass also will be increasing. Size increases, molar mass increases, means what? That difficult to bring take the molecules away from each other when the size is more. Okay, and now here it is very well proved by the experimental result. To look at this next example, this is, you take this R means one some CH3 or any one fixed one, everywhere R is there. But here R with chlorine and R with CH2 14 unified mass mole. This is 14 unified mass mole, which is not there here. Here again one more 14 more than this. That means from left hand side to right hand side, the molecular mass increases, the molecular size increases. Otherwise the CCl, same bond is there. The CCl polarity will be almost same, but here it is a proof that boiling point increases means as the molecular mass or molecular size increases, boiling point increases. This is only one halogen and alkyl group size becoming bigger and bigger. But the second, next, third example is that what is the same hydrocarbon? It is meat only, all single carbon. But number of halogen increases. Number of halogen increases mean molecular size will increase, molecular mass will increase, become heavier and heavier, and therefore it will be increasing the boiling point. Okay, because the reason is, even though the attraction is taking place between the polarity, which is mainly decided by the electronegativity difference, in addition to this dipole-dipole attraction, even the next time will be explaining about at last about the London force, that also will be acting. That what is that? That is whenever two molecules come closer, their body interaction, the surface area will decide. What is the, because one molecule electron cloud will be attracted by the nuclear charges of the other molecule, and other molecule electron cloud will be attracted by this one. That is naturally taking place. That is that the more is the surface area, this is this much surface area, that means they will come closer like this. Now suppose in the small molecule, the surface area is small, so only a small interaction through the surface area. So that is the reason when the molecular size is more, that interaction between the molecules will be stronger. If the molecular size is smaller, the interaction will be smaller. And interaction smaller means boiling point will be less, and other properties also accordingly we will see. Okay, now this last example is, here the second factor is that it is depending upon the polarity. Polarity means what is that? Boiling point of more polar will be having more intermolecular force of attraction, and therefore more boiling point. See, less polar means less intermolecular force. Because polarity means what? That I don't know that this, I just told delta minus delta plus only. But how much delta plus? How much delta minus? First of all, this delta plus and delta minus, these two are less than 1.602 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. What is this 1.602 into 10 to the power minus 19? It is the quantity of the charge in coulomb possessed by unit positive charge, that is cation, and unit negative charge, that is anion. So unit positive charge, unit negative charge, their magnitude is this much. I told you it is not ions, it is a feeling, it is not a charge, it is a feeling. That is why it is positive dominating feeling and negative dominating feeling. So definitely the magnitude will be much smaller than this one. Remember that. But among the delta plus in this molecule, HCl molecule, and delta plus in HBr molecule, and what is that difference? That is polarity will differ. So now see that polarity is favoring here. In this example, look at the HCl is having more polarity because Cl is more electronegative than Br. So it is more polar. But still, the boiling point is in the other way. The reason is there are two factors, and that what is dominating factor that will decide. You and me cannot say. Whenever two factors are involved in a particular boiling point or in a polarity or intermolecular forces, which is more will dominate, which is more, you and me cannot say. We have to find out from the experimental result. This is the experimental result, the boiling point measurement, and it shows that the polarity is not a dominating factor, size is a dominating factor, because that much large increase in size, you see that much large increase in size. But you look at this molecule, pH 3, in the periodic table, after phosphorus, here in the same period, sulfur will come. From left hand side to right hand side, size decreases, and that also a very small, that is phosphorus size and sulfur size is almost very close. Okay, as per the trend in periodicity, the sulfur is slightly smaller than phosphorus otherwise, and what about that similar size? Okay, so these two are similar size, I can say. Okay, slightly smaller this one. But what about the electronegativity? Electronegativity of sulfur is more. Electronegativity from left hand side to right hand side increases. So when compared to phosphorus, sulfur is more electronegative. So now see that here this is pH bond, and here it is SH bond, and here there will be a delta minus delta plus, here also delta minus delta plus, okay. And this is more electronegative, sulfur is more electronegative, na? So this quantity of this delta minus will be more. The delta minus is more, that means here it is, I can say this polarity is more polar and this is less polar. I am not saying it, look at the boiling point. Here it is less polar, that means less intermolecular force of attraction, less boiling point. Here more polar, more intermolecular force of attraction, more boiling point. Okay, so boiling point is actually depending upon the intermolecular force of attraction, and the intermolecular force of attraction, that is dipole-dipole attraction, will depend on molecular size and molar mass and polarity. Okay, so molecular mass or molecular size is very large mean, and that will be dominating factor. This will not play a role. If the size is like isomers and all, it is that the same molecular mass, same size, shape may change. That also we'll discuss in the some other category. And that I mean the similar molecular mass, then that molecular mass will not play a role and polarity will play a role. That is this last example. Okay, no.